This is a sample make of my next sewing pattern release. See the link for yesterday's part 4. The main fabric of the jacket is completed. We now move on to the lining. To summarise, stitch the bust dart, stitch the shoulder dart, join the back neck facing to the back lining, creating the pleat for ease in the back piece. Join the shoulder facing to the sleeve lining. Then we will join the front lining to the front facing, which is part of the fronts. Then we will join the raglan seams. So we will join the back neck facing to the back. I have stitched the pleat in the back and pressed it to one side. I have stay stitched this edge and clipped it at intervals. This will help with matching the opposing curves. Pin and baste ready for machining. Now for the sleeves and the sleeve facings. I have stitched the shoulder dart and stay stitched the curved edge and snip just short of the stitching. Pin, baste and stitch both sleeves. So that's the back and sleeve facings attached. The seams are pressed down. A pressing ham is useful here to keep a good shape. Next, we join the sleeves to the back, matching double notches. Again, this curve needs to be stay stitched and snipped. The raglan sleeves are now joined to the back. The seams are pressed down towards the back. So back to the main garment. These are the front facings. We will join the left front lining to the left front facing. Again, these are opposing curves. And the same with the right side. Right front lining to right front facing. I have to be careful here as my bias cut front is inclined to stretch. Match the markings carefully. Here my lining is an inch, 2.5 centimetres shorter. In the final version the difference should be a half an inch, 1.75 centimetres. Stop stitching about 5 inches, 7.25 centimetres short to give us room to complete the hem. The front linings are attached to the front facings and the seams pressed towards the lining. We can now complete the raglan seam, joining the sleeve facing lining to the front facing lining. Turn the jacket inside out. Join the sleeve facing sleeve lining to the front facing lining along the raglan seam. Opposing curves again, so snip at close intervals. The seam is pinned and I'll baste before machining. Pinning, then basting before machining helps you with accurate matching of seams. The remaining raglan seams are stitched. The seam is pressed down towards the fronts. The sleeve lining and the lining side seam can be stitched in one go. So, right sides together. Grab the seams. Pin, baste and stitch from lining cuff to lining hem. The lining is now complete and in one piece. Lining sleeve, seams and side seams are pressed open. Next we make the collar. Continues tomorrow in part 6, collar and cuffs. In the meantime, check out my sewing pattern page and all my free content. Thank you for watching.